Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to our online classes. Now, though we have completed chapter 6 of English grammar, let us proceed to our next chapter, that is chapter 7, tenses. Okay. Now, I hope you all remember about the tenses. There are three types of tenses, and this topic is not new for you, as you have studied in the previous classes that tenses normally there are three types of tenses, that is present tense, past tense and future tense. Okay, now in this topic today you will study about the present tense. First, let me explain you what do you mean by tenses. Okay, now tenses are words that are used to refer time. Okay, time, it may be past also. Past means which is already finished. Present means which is going on, and future means which is going to come. Okay, these three tenses I hope you have studied in the previous classes also and you remember also. Got it? Now let us study in detail about the present tense. Okay? Now see, students, what do you mean by simple present tense? Now, first of all, the simple present tense is formed by using the first form of verb. Okay, means now first form of verb, however it may be s also or es also. Got it? And secondly, in the tenses there are four types. Okay, that is simple present tense, continuous present tense, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. Okay, now if you can see this example, you will see the man digs means still, means the man is digging. I mean, it is the man digs. Okay, it is in present tense, the work is in present going on. Okay, next let us focus on other few examples of simple present tense. Now see, Raju is very happy, or Pinky likes pet animals, Chintu goes to bed early. Now these are few examples of simple present tense. Got it? Now verb is simple present tense. It talks about actions that happen in the present time or regularly, means the action it is in the present. Okay, and regularly it's going on. Is that clear? Now the next example is our cat drinks milk. You can see the picture where the cat is continuing with the verb means, of course you all are aware about the verb. What do you mean by verb? Verb is an action, and here in the picture the action is going on where the cat is drinking the milk. Is that clear? Now if you'll notice in your book, that is page number 54, you are having this chart. Now see, students, this chart is completely taken from the book only for your proper understanding. Okay, where you can understand with the help of the chart properly. Hence the same chart is given here on the screen, and you can take your book and start studying if you have any confusion or anything. Is that clear? Now see, students, in this chart if you see properly, there are three types of present tense, past tense and future tense, where you are having complete all the four forms, that is simple, continuous, perfect tense and perfect continuous tense. Now here there are different rules given for each tense. Okay, in present tense, if you see in simple, There is verb plus you will add s or es, means verb. Any verb with the verb you will add s or es. Now if your present tense is in the continuous form, you will use is, am, are plus verb plus ing. Suppose studying, running, laughing, means everywhere you will add ing. Is that clear? Now is in the perfect tense, what you will use is have or has. Okay, and the continuous tense, perfect continuous with have and has, what you will add? Been. What you will add is been and ing in the verb. These rules are particularly for present tense. Now let us move on to past tense. Past means already the work is done. Is that clear? Now here in the simple you will use simple verb, okay, but in continuous tense with ing, what you will add? Was and were. Okay, why was and were? Because your tense is already completed. Is that clear? Next, with perfect tense, what you will add is had. What you will add? Had. Is that clear? And in perfect continuous tense, you will add, with had you will add been. Is that clear? Now the next is future tense, means what is going to come in your life. Now in future tense, students, in simple future tense you will add will and shall with the verb. Okay, again I am telling you, what do you mean by verb? Verb is an action. Okay, now with continuous tense you will add will, shall plus be. Okay, means I'll be running, I'll be watching this, I'll be doing that, this, like this. Okay, plus verb plus ing. Okay, means with shall and will, what you will use is be. Is that clear? Next, in perfect tense you will use have. With shall and will, what you will use is have. Okay, now in continuous tense you will use been with shall and will, means will or shall, have, been and your verb. Is that clear? With ing. These are few rules which you will use in your all the three tenses. Got it? Now, what do you mean by first form, second form or third form? Now students, see, let us study this chart of the three forms. Now see, first, second and third form are used in your singular and plural form. Okay, means first of all, forms means your affirmative, negative and interrogative. Okay, your second column is for singular, means in singular sentence what you will use, and your third form is for plural. Is that clear? Means person, first person, second person and third person. Now your three forms of the sentences are affirmative, that is positive sentence, negative, you all are aware, negative, interrogative, that is question type. Is that clear? Now third column is for singular form, means all the singular sentences, and the last column is for plural. Is that clear? Now let us start. First is affirmative, means I love apples. Okay, but if your subject becomes in plural, I will become we, that is we love apples. Got it? Now negative, I do not like apples. Plural, what it will be? We do not like apples. Okay, and if you ask question to someone, that is interrogative form, it will be do I like apples or do we like apples. Is that clear? Now I hope you have understood these three forms. Now let us proceed to the second person. Okay, now for second person you will use you, means I is first and you is your second person. Okay, now let us start with the first sentence, that is affirmative. You will use, suppose if I say you write well, okay, This is your positive sentence. And if I say negative for someone, I will say, you do not write well. Got it? And if I ask question to someone, that is interrogative. Do you write well? Got it? And same thing, if we use for the plural forms, what you will use is, you write well, you do not write well, and do you write well? Got it? Now, third person. Third is, means directly, not contacted with the first and second, that is directly the third person. Now, positive sentences, she reads, means she reads. Negative, he does not read or she does not read. Now, interrogative is, does he read and does she read? See students, what is the difference between second person and third person? Second person is a person where we talk directly to the person. Means suppose if I am talking to you. So I am the first person and you are the second person. And if we talk about someone else, that is he or she, the person will be the third person. Means neither I, neither you. The third person means already the third person. Got it now? Don't get confused. Okay, third person means third person. Neither you, neither I. Got it? Now, if the same forms, if you use in the plural form, how you will use? Instead of he and she, the sentence will start from they. Is that clear? They read, they do not read, they walk, they do not walk, do they read, do they walk, like this. Okay, means these examples on my own, I am giving you a few examples. So I hope you have understood it. Got it? Now students, next is present continuous tense. Let us focus on how present continuous tense are written. As I have shown you the chart, but still let us continue with particularly. Just see the picture. Is, are, or am. Plus verb plus ing. Once again, I am telling you, what do you mean by verb? Verb is an action. Got it? Now, here, let us study few examples of continuous tense. See, Jason is washing his bicycle. Okay, what he's doing is washing his bicycle. ing is added. And though Jason is a single person, what you have used is. If there will be a group of persons sitting over here, what you will use, or if the sentence will be in the plural form, what you will use are. Okay, what you will use is, instead of is, what you will use are. Got it? Now, the next is, I am walking to the bookshop. Now see here, am walking. Why? Because here the sentence is in the singular form. If it will be in the plural form, what you will use here? Are walking. Okay, what you will use here is are walking. Okay, now the next is, see here, the chart of continuous tense. As I told you that in continuous tense, again you are having singular and plural, and I have given you the example while I was dictating the singular examples, but still see here that there is a chart of first, second and third person with singular and plural. Now see, I am singing. Instead of I, what you will use? We. Now in the negative, what you use is not. And in the plural sentence, instead of I am not singing, what you will use is we are not singing. So what is changed over here? Only the subject, that is I, is changed in we, because I is a singular form and we is your plural. Is that clear? Now, the next is second person. So second person means I am the first person and if you are the second person. Now see, you are singing. Plural, you are singing. You are not singing, you are not singing. And are you singing? Are you singing? Means there won't be any change in the second person. Got it? The change will be in the first person and third person. Got it? There will not be change in any second person sentences. Neither in affirmative nor in negative and nor in interrogative. There is only change in the third person where he will become they. He or she will become they. Okay. Now he is singing, they are singing. He is not singing, they are not singing. Is he singing? Are they singing? Got it? Even if there will be a she, you will use they only. Got it? Now, the next is uses of present continuous tense. Now, see students, to indicate an action on now. Now, see, here few book examples only I'm explaining you. That is, the baby is sleeping now. What the baby is doing? The baby is sleeping now. Shyam is playing with his friends. Means here, students, the verb is still going on. Okay. The verb is still going on. Still they are, still the baby is sleeping. Still the Shyam is playing. Got it? Now, to express an action which is likely to happen in future, what you will use? They are leaving for Bangalore tomorrow. Or we are going for a movie this evening. Means you have not yet seen the movie. You are planning to go for the movie. Got it? This is the form of near future tense. Third is to express an action which may not be actually going on at time of speaking. Okay? That is, I am reading a fiction these days. Okay? Arun is preparing for NEET. These are few examples where the actually it is on at the time of speaking. Okay? Now, the next is present perfect tense. Now, let us study few examples on present perfect tense. Now, see students, I go to school every morning. Okay, this is present tense. The next is he goes to school every morning. Now, see, I go to and he goes to. Okay, this is first person and this is second person. I is first person and he is second person. Next, here, if you see, there is a chart on present perfect tense, which you can study from your book also. Here again, you will study about the rules of present perfect tense. That is have, has. Okay. Now, students, here, present perfect tense, it denotes an action that has just completed. Okay. And it also denotes the action that has been continuous form. Okay. Continuous form, the past up to present moment. Now, see, what are the rules you will follow? First is affirmative, as I told you before, that you will use has and have. Negative, you will use have, has, not. Okay, because it is negative. And interrogative, what you will use is question mark with the subject. Okay, what you will use is question mark with the subject. Now, let us study it. Now, see students here. First person, second person, third person, as usual, there are three forms of the sentence. Now, let me only give you the examples of it. First, we'll study the singular form. I have completed my work. If it will be in the plural, what you will use is we have completed. Again, the next is in the negative. I have not completed my work. Plural will be we have not completed. Okay. And if I ask the question, how I'll ask? If the question is asked in the interrogative form, have I completed my work or have we completed our work? Now, this is the first person about the work done. Now, the same sentences you will use for the second person. Okay, that is you. Right now, I was using I because it is first person. Now, it is you. Now, if I ask you the question, how I'll ask, you have completed your work or you have not completed? And have you completed? And as I told you before also, please keep in mind that second person rules will not change for singular and plural. For singular and plural, the rules will be common for the second person. Now, third person, of course, he or she will change in they. Okay, now just see, he has completed his work. Then in the plural, what you will use is they have completed their work. Now, the negative form is he has not completed his work and they have completed their work. And interrogative, has he completed this work, his work, and have they completed their work? Got it? Now, these are the rules of present perfect tense. Okay. Now, how you will use present perfect tense? Now, see students, these are few examples where you are having four different examples for four different uses. The first use is to express an action which has just been completed, means we have just completed our work. Now, second is to express an action which began in past and has continued up to present. That is, she has lived in this city for 10 years. Okay. Now, the next is to express an action which happened in the past. That is, they have seen the Taj Mahal. Okay. The last rule is to indicate a past event for which time is not mentioned. That is, Mr. Smith has lost the key of his car. Got it? Now, these are few rules of different types of past, present perfect tense. Okay. Now, present perfect continuous tense means, again, you will use ing. Got it? Now, let us see the example. The child has been sleeping for 3 hours. For how many hours last the child is sleeping for 3 hours? Okay. Now, the next is, as I told you, that for continuous tense, what you will use has or have been. Okay. Now, your next sentence is, the boys have been playing football since this morning. Okay, means the boys have been playing football since this morning. Now, just see the rules for this. First of all, see students, present perfect continuous tense refers to an action, okay, that has been going on continuously over a period of time and starting in the past and continuing right up to the present. Okay. Now see here, the present perfect continuous tense is formed in the following ways: as usual, positive, that is affirmative, negative, and interrogative. First is your subject, then you will use has or have, then been, then your verb, and then ing. Now let us study few examples on these. Again, first person, second person, and third person. Now, in first person, of course, I. So, I have been waiting for a long time. Now, here, singular, if you use I, what you will use in plural? We. Okay. The next is, of course, have been will become have not been. Why? Because it is negative. And here in the plural, what you will use? We have not been. Got it? Now, the next is interrogative, where the question is asked that, have I been doing? And here, I will become we. That is, have we been doing our project? Got it? Now, the next is second form. Of course, second is you. So, in affirmative, you will use you have been writing. Okay. And in plural form, what you will use? Again, there won't be any change in the second person. Okay. Singular and plural will be common for second person. Got it? So, all these rules are common for singular and plural both. Now, the third person, of course, he or she will become they. What it will become is they. But see students, there is a change in interrogative where it is given, have she been staying here? And your plural form will be, have they been staying here. Okay. Now here she will become they. He will become they. And she will become they. Is that clear? I hope you have understood. And now let us study the rules or uses of present continuous tense. Now see, to refer an action which began in past and recently stopped, that is, she has been studying whole night, or I have been waiting for you since morning. Okay. Now, this is all about the present tense. Okay. I hope you have understood all the four types of the present tense. And if any doubts, you can contact me. Now, students, your previous chapter answers I have given you, and one exercise I have given you for practice. I hope you all have completed. So send the homework of previous chapter also, that is chapter 6. And very soon, I'll give you the exercise of chapter 7. And one or two exercises I'll give you for practice. Another, I'll give you the answers. So please practice the exercise before I send you. Got it? I hope you can do it. And very soon you will get the answers of the exercise also. Okay. Now, thank you, and send the homework. Okay. So, thank you.